This is taken from the data sheet of 741C. Supply voltage shown is plus minus 10 volt minimum and plus minus 18 volt maximum. This means if we give more than plus minus 18 volt, IC may fail. If we give less than plus minus 10 volt, IC may not work. But my experience is, even you give less than plus minus 10 volt, IC still works. But there is no guarantee of working from supplier or manufacturer. Now here we see we have shown the equal voltage, plus also 15, minus also 15. Whether we have to compulsory give equal voltage, plus and minus? No, it is not required. Suppose we give with plus side plus 10 volt and minus side minus 15 volt, then what happens? Suppose our signal level is more, then if we give plus side 10 volt, say, less voltage compared to negative side, then positive signal will saturate earlier, it will clamp. Negative side still will work. If our signal range is low, then there's no problem. We can give positive side and negative side different voltage. Now output voltage swing. Suppose we give plus minus 15 volt to power supply. Then maximum output voltage will not be plus minus 15, it will be less. It will be plus minus 13 volt, as shown in the data sheet of 741C. This is called the output voltage swing. Let us see what happens. Suppose our output signal is very high because of more gain, and signal should be 15 volt, but our supply also is 15 volt, then output will not remain 15, it will clamp at 13 volt itself, plus side also, minus side also. This is because the linear IC is having two transistors at output and V0 is here, this is output. Because of drop in this transistor, output voltage will be less than supply voltage. Output short circuit current of the 741C is 25 milliampere. This IC had a special current limiting circuit at the output. Because of that, even output is short circuited, current will be limited to 25 milliampere. This is at 25 degree. At different temperature, current may be little different. This is to protect the IC from failing. Now input offset voltage. What is input offset voltage? We have a linear IC. We suppose we give 0 volt to plus terminal and minus terminal also. Output should be 0, but it does not happen. Because positive and negative terminal are not identical exactly, so output will not be 0, it will have some value. That value is plus minus 15 millivolt in the case of 741C. To remove this, or to make 0, there are two pins, offset null, pin number 1 and 5. What we do? Across pin number 1 and 5, we connect a potentiometer, and in middle pin we give minus supply, and we vary this. We give 0 volt here and here both, and we vary here until output becomes 0. This is required if we require high accuracy. If accuracy requirement is not high, this potentiometer is not required. Now input voltage range is shown plus minus 13 volt and differential input voltage is shown plus minus 30 volt. What happens, even we keep this limit to input, because of spikes, voltage may cross 30 volt and IC may fail. To protect the IC, we connect two anti-parallel diodes across positive terminal and negative terminal. The diode used by me in my circuit is 1N4148. This anti-parallel diode keep limited voltage across minus and plus terminal, and so IC does not fail. Now transient response time. Earlier in part 1 we have discussed the slew rate. In addition to slew rate, there is a rise time and there is a overshoot. Rise time of 741 is 0.3 microsecond. This means output will be slow and overshoot is 5%. We will see what is overshoot and rise time. Suppose our input is like this, then output will not follow input. Output will be like this. This is overshoot. If the supply is 10 volt and this is 0.5 volt, so this becomes 5%. And this is rise time. If input frequency is low, overshoot is not the problem. But if input frequency is high, then this is to be taken care. Output impedance. This IC output is not perfectly regulated. It has some equivalent output resistance which is called Z0. When you connect a load, because of this resistance, when current flows, a drop happens and output becomes unregulated. Higher the value of load, higher the drop will be there. Instead of resistance, if we connect a capacitor, then because of RC, output will become further slow and we will not get the proper output. So, during design, this impedance should be taken care by proper selecting IC or proper design. Supply voltage variation reduction. What happens when we give power supply regulated? Even it is regulated, because of load or other thing, it doesn't remain regulated. Here I have shown one IC, but in complex circuit, there will be many more linear IC, there may be many more digital IC, there will be many IC will be switching, transiently switching, it will draw the high frequency current. Because of high frequency current, here high frequency spikes comes. And this spike pass over here. So that spike start appearing at the output also. To reject that, this is called the supply voltage variation reduction. For high frequency range, we connect two capacitors. I have connected 0.1 microfarad capacitor, positive terminal also, negative terminal also. This can be metallized polyester capacitor, or we use ceramic capacitor also. Because of that, this transient will not pass over here.